historically, there's always been this division and this understanding among behavioral scientists that, you know, biology and genes had an impact on you when you were born, and then environment takes over after that. And through the years, this has been debated, and then, you know, it's been nature versus nurture. And there's so many different ways that these processes are intertwined. And one way is through gene-environment correlations. So gene-environment correlations look at the degree to which people's environments and experiences are to some degree steered by their inheritance. And so there's different ways. I mean, for example, the family that that I was raised in, or that you were raised in, the families that we were raised in, these families are not randomly assigned to us. Mine had my biological father and my biological mother, and the environment that I was raised in was part of their extended phenotype. So people, you know, when they're in their biological households, are already surrounded by a genetic influence. And then in addition to that, as we go across our lives, we select and modify our environments. And so this is basically, this is called a gene-environment correlation, an active gene-environment correlation. So active gene-environment correlations are when people select and modify their environments, and, like, for example, their peer group. So inside any school, there's a wide variety of kids. But based upon your temperament, you may want to hang out with different kids, and they may want to hang out with you differently. So I think it's important to realize that these aspects of the environment reflect a lot of your inheritance on an individual level.